Thank you, Madam Chair. Dear colleagues, we understand the major concern with the new Ukrainian law on education has raised. It concerns a very delicate and sensitive matter in a multi-ethnic, multi-language and multicultural country, a country which is home to almost 130 nationalities and consisting of a population where 22% is made up of ethnic minorities, with Russia being the largest one, representing almost 17% of the population. Taking this into account, we would like to express our disappointment with the fact that the Venice Commission has not been consulted well in advance for an opinion on such an important question with major implication for the Ukrainian society. Nevertheless, we welcome the post-factum submission of the text to the Venice Commission. There are namely concerns that some provision of the new law contradicts some parts of the Article 10 of the Constitution of Ukraine that declare free development, use and protection of Russian and other languages of ethnic minorities. The discrimination of ethnic minorities and the exclusion of their languages from state affairs, mass media, cinema, and especially education can be regarded as manifestation of hard assimilations, various harmonious integrations as also outlined in the framework convention, should be the way to build peaceful and diverse societies in which human rights are respected, protected, and treated with high priority. We consider that a new law on education is in current form can substantially limit the rights of ethnic minorities, and therefore it is necessary to wait for the opinions and reports of the expert bodies of the Council of Europe concerning the provision of the new law, which could be in line with the European Charter for Regional and Minority Languages. Therefore, we will support the demands of the Assembly, which include bringing Ukrainian legislation in line with international law, treaties and conventions signed by Ukraine in order to fully comply with their international obligations. We find it also important to consider the Venice Commission's opinion, which will be delivered by the end of 2017. We therefore welcome the outline of the different concerns expressed in the resolution and find that the different proposals suggested in the document should be taken into account by Ukraine authorities when following up on the new law on education. Thank you very much.